So let's talk about how to process this and how to make this into a terrain. This is a two-dimensional DXF, right?
Two-dimensional.
We are able to import three-dimensional as well, but this is going to be a 2D. So what you are going to do now, you will use these terrain lines and then the numbers on top to turn this into a three-dimensional model.
Yeah. These are the lines that the original designer set this here to make me understand that that's the 133.5 meters above the sea level. So I will use these values.
Why don't you start the process, explain how you start, and then while you do it, I'll tell more about the terrain tools.
Yeah, okay. Before I do that, let me just show you that actually all the terrain tools, the terrain related tools are here. This is what you will cover a little bit further in detail. And when you would like to process a terrain data manually based on a drawing, you will go with this option. Other than that, you can load a file which contains the XYZ coordinates, then you can work with that. But if you have a drawing like this, like a 2D drawing which you would like to manually process, then you will go with this option. So I start with this one, and then I select this by open chain. These here, these are what we call open chains. This is a series, a chain of lines.
Like a polyline.
And then if I use this, I can actually simply click on one of them, like this here, and I just type the same value that I can see there. It's 133.5.
Mm-hmm.
Enter. And then now the software turned it into a terrain line, and then I can keep going on and processing this data.
Perfect. Meanwhile, while you do this, I'll entertain the viewers with some fun facts about the terrain.
Okay.
So as you are going to see in a couple of minutes, the ARCHLine terrains are going to be a three-dimensional morphs, like bodies. If you want to add any kind of plateaus, roads, or any kind of protrusion onto this terrain, you first have to generate it. So you are going to end up with one solid to which you can add additional tools. These tools can be, for instance, building volumes, which are very good for shadow analysis. We are going to see that later on. You can add additional parts to it. You can make ditches into that. You can change the pitch of the cutouts. And eventually you will have a terrain which has multiple portrayal options. You could have level lines, you could have a triangulated form, grid, that was the word I was looking for. Any kind of portrayal mode. Once you are done with setting up the terrain lines, now nothing happens so far. So what do we have to do to generate this input?
Yeah, to tell the software that I'm actually done with the selection and I don't want to keep going on and select more and more and more lines. Just as in other cases, when you are in a loop like this, you can instruct the software to finish it by just hitting the Enter key. And then the software finishes it. I was on the other screen. So you just hit Enter, and then you have the terrain. But to be able to visualize it...
We don't see it yet. So that's because of the layer walk, as you remember. Yeah. We disabled a couple of things from our drawing, including the terrain itself.
Yeah. So even if I click here to build up the 3D, I won't see anything. So I need to go back here and find it. So there's the terrain, that's right. I actually turn on everything now, and then I use it, and I click
3D hammer again.
3D hammer, and then now I have
and
it.
You end up with the morph. Remember what I mentioned before, now you have one body on which you can add additional